Why are you leaving? Scared of being humiliated?
Looks like you need more training. You are nowhere near ready.
I'm gonna show you what a real dancer looks like. Are you sure about that?
Quiet! Tonight, these seats will be full. Paris will be looking at me, adoring me.
Or not.
I already told you, you are nothing. You will always be nothing.
Only one way to find out. Right here, right now.
Hey everyone, what is up? Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy Kwanzaa, all the holidays that is happening around this time. I just give you all the greetings, all the love as we are ending this year. Y'all, bruh, 2020 is almost over. So let's end it with a bang. For those who are new to my channel, my name is Tia Joy.
Welcome, welcome, girl.
And everyone who is already a part of the fam and newcomers, thank you so much for joining. I really, really appreciate it. This just really just helps enhance my channel. So I just love to see the subscriber numbers just going up. So thank you. I appreciate you. I love you. Thank you so much. I am excited to get into today's dance review. We are 2 out of 1 more left before this year is over, and I am so excited to talk about this dance review. We are going to talk about Leap. Now, before I get this dance review, I just need to do a couple of things. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel, and it's okay. If you don't hit it right now, keep watching, and hopefully along the way, you'll be like,
yo, I like this,
and hit that subscribe button, and check out my other dance reviews that I have done as well if you're not convinced with this dance review. Second thing what I need to do is hit that bell, so that way you can be in the know when I'm loading a video. Leap came out in 2016. It was directed by two people. So we have Eric Sommer and Eric Warren. So these two people, it's so funny how both of them are Eric. So maybe it's Eric or Eric, you know, either or. And it's about an orphan girl named Felicie who is played by Love Fanning. Now, low key, this is actually my first animation movie review. The whole time, if you've seen the rest of my dance reviews, I've been talking about a lot of movies that are famous that are out right now, or maybe they're old, but this is my first animation movie review, so I'm super excited to talk about this because, yo, some of these animation movies, they got some really nice stuff in here. But anyway, but Felicie, she's an orphan girl. Her and her best friend, Victor, who's played by, who is the voice. it's funny how I say played by, but these are voiceovers. So these are people who are playing the voice of these characters. So for Victor, it is
Dane DeHaan.
And so both of them, they are at the same orphanage, and Felicie, she is a dancer. She loves dancing, but also she has this thing where she wants to escape the orphanage because she has this huge dream, which is to be a ballet dancer. And so also Victor, he has this beautiful dream and he wants to be an inventor. He wants to invent things that you don't even think about. So I like how he has this little way of trying to invent the wings, invent how to fly, invent how to sharpen something. Like, he just wants to be a very famous inventor, and the only way you know he can do that is leaving the orphanage. And he shows Felicie a picture of Paris and an orpheum where ballet is done, and he's just saying, yo, let's run away together so we can go to Paris, hit the train to Paris, and we can fulfill our dreams. And that's exactly what they do. And so Felicie, as her and Victor, they're in Paris, touchdown, she sees the picture that Victor gives her in Paris, and she ends up going. She sees a beautiful ballet dancer. She's like, yo, like, this is my dream, this is what I want to do. And she ends up running into a woman named Odette, who is the voice of Carly Rae Jepsen. And so Odette, she is working, and she's really has a limp. She used to be a ballet dancer, so right now she's just working for a lady and being her cleaner. And when Felicity, as she's helping her out, she ends up running to Camille, who is the voice of Maddie Ziegler. So if you don't know who Maddie Ziegler is, she also was in Dance Moms. So, but anyway, but when she sees Camille, Felicity has this very special, special music box that it was given to her mom. And so Camille ends up being a jerk. And when the mail came, and it was for Camille, because Camille, she is a ballet dancer. She wants to be perfect. She wants to be the prima ballerina, and she wants to train at the very high class training at the Orpheum Theater. And with these girls, they are getting ready for a big production. And so pretty much Felicity ends up taking the letter that Camille was supposed to get to go to train at the academy at the Orpheum, and she ends up going as Camille, disguised as her, and also it's an opportunity for her to live her dream, which is being trained to be a wonderful ballet dancer. And these girls, all of them, they're getting ready to do an audition for the Nutcracker, and they have a special character that they want to go for so they can dance on stage at the Orpheum Theater. And so with Felicity, she's just living her dream, and it's just wonderful the fact that she gets this opportunity. An orphan girl doesn't have much, but one thing she has is a dream, and she goes after it. And so I'm just gonna get to a couple of my favorite scenes that I absolutely love about this movie. So here we go. So the first one is when Felicity's very excited. She's dancing at the Orpheum, she's in this academy, and she's learning she's actually getting some real ballet training, because she hasn't been trained in ballet. So a lot of these girls, they know all these foot positions, and she has to go from scratch learning the positions in first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Well, skip the third, because mostly when it comes to training for ballet, you only learn the first, second, fourth, and fifth, and learning leaps, the splits, Alison Cones, jumps in for Aishapé, Shawn Jamaz. Like, she's learning all these ballet terms. Yes, I do know these ballet terms because I take ballet. Okay, so once you win ballet, it's technically key. Ballet is the foundation of all dance styles, so if you haven't taken ballet yet, make sure you do so. It really helps you with technique and posture. But anyway, but I just really love this scene with Felicity when her and Victor goes into, what was it? It's like they go to this bar and they're in Paris, and I just love this because she is living her dream in Paris, and just to see her be free and dancing and just having a great time, and she's like dancing on the tables and everybody's like cheering her on, and she's doing her ballet moves that she's learning from the academy because she picks up pretty quickly. And I just really like how she's just tap dancing. This girl was killing. I'm like, okay, Felicity, like, she was having the time of her life, okay? And I just really love her and how free she is. And I love Victor. Victor's like, that's my girlfriend, that's my girl. It's just so funny and cute, but you can tell she really, really loves dancing. And I'm gonna go into a little bit later, between Dance with the Heart and Dancing to be Perfect. It's gonna come with that. So my second favorite scene that I love in this movie is when Camille and Felicity is battling. So a little bit later, you know, the truth is revealed, and Camille, she ends up training and, you know, to be a part of the Nutcracker. Well, she ends up, you know, she ends up training to be a part of the Nutcracker. And so I just really love the scene between Camille and Felicity when they're dancing, because Camille thinks she's better than her. Camille doesn't think that Felicity is really anything because not only of who she is, but where she came from. Because Camille, she's a rich girl. She has been trained since she was a kid. She's this person who feels like she's better. She feels like she is entitled to a lot of things because of who she is and also who her mom is as well. And so with Camille, she doesn't really think Felicity is nothing because she's an orphan girl. She pretty much wears the same clothes throughout the whole movie, so she thinks she's nothing. So I really love the scene between them two battling, and she's really trying to prove to Felicity that she's better. And I just really love how they're like dancing on stage, and next thing you know, they start running on the chairs in the Orpheum, and then next thing you know, they're out in the big hallway, everyone's there, and they're dancing. And I just really love the jump that Felicity's been always wanting to do. She ends up doing it, and I just love how she proved Camille wrong. But once again, the two girls are battling, so it's fun, and it's like like a ballet battle, let's go. I mean, how often do you see ballet battles happening in a dance movie? So the fact that they're battling, like, it was cute, and they're little girls, so they killed it. And so I just really, really love this scene because it's just cool to see them two go head to head between the girl who thinks she's somebody versus the girl who just knows she's something great, and she's still trying to figure out exactly what that is. And so what breaks it all down to at the end of the day is when they were both asked, why do you dance? And so I just really love that scene. The lesson that I definitely learned in this movie is two. Number one is just be yourself and who you are and not be ashamed of it. And I know with Felicie, she had to learn that because one thing she knew is she loved to dance. And I love how Odette kept on asking her, like, why do you dance? Why do you dance? And she just really didn't have a specific answer, but she finally got to the point of having an answer to that question. And she just had to be herself. She had to, like, understand that, no, you didn't come from something great, but at the same time, one thing that I do appreciate is the fact that she was given a chance. And that makes a huge difference when it comes to opportunities. It's giving people a chance. And the fact that she did, and at first she was looked down upon when it came to her first coming into the academy, but then she just kept growing because she also got the help of Odette, who helped her and started training with her because she knew that she loved dancing. Also, Odette saw a lot of herself in Felicie, and that's what brought them two closer together. The second lesson that I learned in this movie is, and it's the thing is, it's a really simple lesson, but once we do it, we don't really think about it too much until we really think deep about it. And so the second lesson I learned is, it's the simple things that makes us great. For instance, when Odette, when she was first training Felicie, the first assignment that she gave her was hit the bell and don't splash. Now, when Felicie said that, she heard about that, she was like, hit the bell and don't splash. Like, she thought it was stupid. Like, what the heck? Like, I don't get what this lesson is. And this lesson, as I saw, it reminded me of the Karate Kid. So with either the new one or the old one. So for instance, with Mr. Miyagi and Danny, Mr. Miyagi was telling him, okay, clean the cars. But there was a certain way he wanted to clean the cars. Then when he told him to, okay, I want you to paint the fence, there was a certain way he wanted him to paint the fence. And then when he was like, okay, I need you to scrub this wood so that way it's smooth and no splinters. But there was a way he wanted to do it. And even with the new one, with Mr. Han and Dre, when Dre, he had this big, huge issue of getting his coat and putting it on the floor. And so I like how Mr. Han, he took something that he struggled with and used it as a training tool. So the thing with all three of these, with hitting the bell, all this chores that he felt like he was doing, and learning how to pick up his coat from the floor, these people who are training them, they take something simple for training that they end up using for a huge lesson that helps all in general. So to really break that down, so the whole point of Felicie hitting the bell and not splashing is she thought it was dumb. Like, this is dumb, this is hard, I keep splashing, I don't get it. But every time she landed, she kept landing hard, but the true lesson was to land soft. Because it helps with jumps like Chanjamas Royale, Aisha Pays, or Sote jumps, or Seasons, whatever jump is helping you to land softer. And when she finally understood this, she's like, okay, this is the why I'm learning how to hit the, it's not about the bell. It wasn't about the bell the whole time. It was really about the landing. And so with the Karate Kid, with the old one, it wasn't about chores. It was about training the wrist. It was about training the arms to defend yourself when you get a punch. With the new one, it's the same thing. It's not just about putting to help him to take the coat and put it on the bin from the ground and put it on the tree, but it was also about training his arms to go up, to go down, the way he put it on, the way he takes it off. It was training. So sometimes we think the object of what we're doing is stupid, but it ain't about the object. It's about the form. And so I just really loved how with this lesson, with her hitting the bell, how she used something simple and I love how all three of them never tell you why you're doing it. They just say to do it, and it's your job to humble yourself to the person who's training you and just do the job. And then finally, when you get frustrated and you finally calm down and they show you why, now it's like, oh. And I just really love with both the karate, even though this is not the movie, but it's just funny with the karate kids how both of the guys, Danny and Dre, when they finally understood, they're like, wow, that's why. So now they want to go even more. And then with Dre, same thing. He's like, now, first of all, he learned not to put his coat on the floor no more. But also with Felicie, she learned how to land softer, and she ended up being, you know, great in her class and learning how to land. One thing that I also liked about the training that Odette was doing with Felicie is that they were just using what they have. And so with Camille, you know, she has these these expensive machines that she used, or ballet bar to use in order for her to train. But with Felicie and Odette, they didn't have those things. So she used a spin wheel. She used just different ways to train Felicie, or what they had around. And it just really shows, you know, that you could really use anything if you just put your mind to it, or if you be creative. So I just really like, even with the other movies with the Karate Kid, how they were training. They didn't go to no training ring or no boxing ring or no special gym just to train for karate lessons. They didn't go to a dojo just to train. They just used the simple, like, they just used what they had. And so I just really like how, you know, if you're dealing with a true master when they can use anything to train you, and it doesn't have to be the obvious of what you think you have to use in order to really train. And that's one thing that I really loved about this movie as well, is just use what you have, and anything is possible. So I just love how it's like, but like I said, the lesson is just don't take something that's simple. And just don't despise the learning. Don't despise the simple training. You just never know. Don't despise you want me to do this, or it's stupid. It's not stupid once you find out why. And so I just really loved how that just all came to play, because just watching that scene, it just reminded me of those two movies. If you haven't seen those, hopefully you watching this, you can go see it. But that's all that I have for this dance movie review. I appreciate all of you for being here and watching this dance and listen to me as I do this dance review. If you liked it, go ahead and hit that like button. Also subscribe, plus the bell, so instantly you'll be notified when I upload a new content. And also let me know what other dance reviews that I have not got on yet that you want to see me do. I will definitely look at those, and I will definitely do that as well. Awesome job to the choreographers. And you know, low key, I didn't even know, like choreographers can get hit up for animation. Low key, I didn't know that, but today I learned. So the choreographers for this movie was Aurele DuPont and Jeremy Bellingard. So both of them, they choreographed for this movie. So I thought it was really cool, because when you see a dance movie in animation, it's cool how you have choreographers who can do animation too. So I didn't know that. So if you knew, like, oh, you can choreograph for our animation as well, if you knew that, like, I'm just learning. So that was really cool. So both of y'all did an amazing job, because one thing I can know about animation, they could do a whole bunch of stuff with dancers than you would in real life. I'm just saying. But anyway, but y'all did a great job, and a great job to all of the voiceover actors. You guys did a great job for this movie. I will list all of you guys in my Dancers Hall of Fame. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I upload new content every single Thursday, so I'll see you guys in the next one. And don't forget to make good choices, okay?